guys. So Robotics Studio is all about designing and creating your own robot. I'm taking this class remotely, and Columbia was kind enough to send me all the equipment I needed. Everything from the 3D printer, soldering equipment, screws, screwdrivers, pliers, everything I pretty much needed to build a robot. And here he is. So my goal for the semester was to build a robot that could walk and dance on two legs. And my inspiration?
DoduoBot, the twin bird Pokemon. It runs faster than it can fly.
So the first thing I did was create some sketches. Right here you see my first ever sketch of DoduoBot. Down here you see my first drawing of his feet, as well as a cross-sectional sketch, again very rough. Over on this side, again some more rough cross-sections, you see my first ideas for what the limbs are actually going to look like. Up here you see me going into a little bit more detail with how the limbs actually attach to the motors. So this is my full sketch of DoduoBot. I spent a long time on this sketch, and here's the side-by-side comparison. I think it's pretty good. On the right, you can see I put three platforms just to give a general idea on where I was going to place all of my electronics. Then I did a few sketches of the walking gait. Here's a bunch of weight and torque and power calculations I did.
So step two is CAD. The first thing I designed were my legs. So as you can see here, we've got two pin joints here. Essentially, this makes this leg a four-bar mechanism. You can drag and drop. See how the leg would actually move. So next we have our body. See right here, I put in all these vents so that the electronics inside will not overheat. Right here you see our electronics, our servo controller, our Raspberry Pi, our voltage regulator, our battery pack, a cross-section view. Again, you can see that we can move our heads. Finally, here's the overall assembly. Again, you can drag and drop his feet, just so you can get an idea of how he would walk in real life.
Here's one of the prints that came out yesterday. It was awful. Look at that. This is supposed to be flat. See how it warps upwards, and this part is just, look at the finish. Terrible. For the third time in a row, my part has failed. And these parts take about 12 hours to print. I purchased an auto bed leveler in hopes that it would fix my issues. It has not. You can see how this side is much thinner than that side, and I have no idea why. This is two-thirds the height that it's supposed to be. See how smooth that is? It's over here. It's supposed to be the same here, and it's not. And so the part isn't as tall as it should be. I don't know why it's causing this. I've changed it each time I tried. I thought it was bed leveling, and then I thought it was the nozzle speed, but I still have no idea why it does this. So these feet, they look good, but like they just aren't stable. Like they keep getting caught on each other, and he's having a really hard time walking with those feet. So I printed him
new set of shoes.
I've been trying to get this guy to walk for the past, like, 2 weeks, testing out, changing parameters every night, and he has just failed to walk every single time. And after I changed out the feet, this is like my third test with these feet, and he's walking already, so let's go.
So for simulating my robot, I used PyBullet, simplified my CAD, and then I developed the URDF to define my robot. Obviously had a little bit of trouble getting the physics of the robot working, just because URDF doesn't support closed loop kinematics, but eventually got it to work. It's actually quite difficult just balancing the robot, let alone walking, so I ended up riding a hill climber to try and optimize the gait. So everything you're seeing right now is the algorithm attempting to train the robot to walk. The whole simulation was actually the last thing I worked on in this project, so it's still a work in progress.
I wanna be the very best, like no one ever was. To catch them is my real test, to train them is my cause.
Challenge alone.